The Hollywood Museum is located in the former Max Factor building, where famous stars of the silver screen like Lucille Ball became a redhead and Marilyn Monroe became a blonde. There are about 10,000 items stored inside the museum,
including this dress worn by Sybil Shepherd on her old show Moonlighting. And this dress worn by Judy Garland in the 1950s version of A Star Is Born.
Mommy Dearest herself, Joan Crawford, has her personal Russian coat here on display. You can also see some dresses here worn by the legendary Elizabeth Taylor. Taylor has had a long, glorified career, many marriages, heartbreaks, and triumphs. Today, she is considered one of the great ones from Hollywood's golden age. The museum pays tribute to many stars from days gone by. Here, all the old-time stars still live on through
memorabilia.
This includes autographs, photos of Vic Tayback, who played the lovable loudmouth owner of Mel's Diner on TV's Alice, to costumes used in the Star Wars movies. Pearl Harbor with Ben Affleck may have been a real bomb, but at the museum you can see the fake bombs used in the movie. Costumes from The Queen from Outer Space with Zsa Gabor on display for fans of classic cheesy 1950s sci-fi flicks. A costume worn by Tia Leone in Jurassic Park 3 when she was almost eaten by a dinosaur is on display at the museum. There's also the model plane from the movie that is positioned like it is going to crash at any moment. This shark head was used in one of the Jaws movies. Sigourney Weaver, recently in the movie Avatar, has made a name for herself over the years. However, her most famous character is Ripley, who battled the perfect organism in 4 different alien movies. A crashed space shuttle from the remake of Planet of the Apes sits among the exhibits at the museum. Costumes from the original Planet of the Apes movies are on display, including Roddy McDowell's Dr. Cornelius costume. A pod from the movie Cocoon can also be seen at the museum. However, you will not feel younger if you stand next to it. The Hollywood Museum also pays tribute to horror films, both old and new. A life-size model of a dead-looking Sarah Michelle Gellar that was used in I Know What You Did Last Summer stands waiting for visitors as they come in. Other exhibits include artificial heads and severed fingers used for shark attack scenes in Deep Blue Sea, as well as rubber mock-ups for monsters from other horror movies. One of the mummies used to replicate Boris Karloff's 1932 version of the mummy looks as if it might awake at any moment. Consider yourself fortunate that screen terrors like Michael Myers and Jason Voorhees are enclosed behind glass windows. Otherwise, you might end up being their next victim. In the museum's basement is a complete mock-up of the jail cell scene from 1991's Silence of the Lambs. The movie centered on an up-and-coming FBI agent, Clary Starling, played by Jodie Foster, who enlists the assistance of the crazy Dr. Hannibal Lecter, played by the brilliant Anthony Hopkins. She does this to capture another serial killer known as Buffalo Bill. In one of the movie's suspenseful scenes, Agent Starling visits Dr. Lecter in a special made cell. He is apparently so dangerous that he is kept under the tightest security in the prison. The mock-up jail cell contains actual drawings used in the movie that are supposed to be Dr. Lecter's, as well as props from the movie, including a fake tabloid paper detailing the FBI's investigation into the Buffalo Bill murders. Marilyn Monroe, born Norma Jean Baker in 1926, is one of Hollywood's most endearing legends. The legend began on August 5, 1962, when she was found dead of an alleged overdose of barbiturates. Her life seemed like a dream on the screen, but a nightmare in private. Her mother was committed to a mental institution when she was young, and she had several marriages, bouts with drugs, and mental issues herself. In a special exhibit, the museum is displaying dresses Marilyn wore in her movies like How to Marry a Millionaire. Also on display is a famous black dress she wore at an RSO event in the 1950s. Her 1961 Cadillac limousine, given to her by 20th Century Fox chief Daryl Zanuck,
was presented
to her along with a solid silver Tiffany keychain with her initials engraved on them, M.M. A chauffeur, Rudy Kautsky, was assigned to be her private driver, but was sworn to secrecy by the movie studio and told not to reveal any details of Marilyn's private life. Marilyn's refrigerator was once painted blue. She did this in a gesture to show how she was feeling inside one particular night. Other personal belongings of Marilyn Monroe's include an unsigned check dated one day before she died. There are also documents related to the famous gown she wore to President Kennedy's birthday, where she sang Happy Birthday, Mr. President. That was just a couple of months before she died. Although Marilyn may have been gone for almost 50 years now, she is still alive in the hearts and minds of many people today. The museum also has odds and ends from celebrities such as Elvis. His personal bathrobe is here. There is also the jeweled robe worn by Ra, played by Jay Davidson, from the movie Stargate. Costumes from the Russell Crowe movie Master and Commander on display here, including the figurehead from the ship Surprise. The whip used by Harrison Ford as Indiana Jones is at the museum. This was a favorite weapon of Jones in the Raiders of the Lost Ark movies. Many times he used it to escape danger, but on occasion he would use his gun. It worked really well in one situation. Screen legend Greta Garbo has one of her dresses on display here in the Hollywood Museum. Roddy McDowell's Powder Room was a famous visiting spot for many Hollywood stars. Today it looks almost ready to accommodate the next Hollywood guest. Want an autograph? The museum has plenty, like this autograph purse from Reese Witherspoon. Many believe a man could fly after seeing Christopher Reeve do it as Superman in 1978. One of the more unusual displays at the museum include the eyeballs that Tom Cruise used in the movie Minority Report. Megan Fox's wardrobe from the movie Transformers is on display at the museum. There are also some off-the-wall exhibits like the White House hotline phone from the Kennedy presidency. Some of the dresses worn by Mae West, one of the original sex sirens of the old silver screen, is on display here. You can also see some props from the first movie to win the Best Movie Oscar in 1927, Wings, with Clara Bow and a very young Gary Cooper. Clara Bow was a big star in those days. In fact, she was the first It Girl. The famous bike from Pee-wee's Big Adventure can be seen here. Props from the 1985 movie Enemy Mine with Lou Gossett Jr. and Dennis Quaid are on display inside the museum. The hapless dog from There's Something About Mary is one of the many exhibits in the museum. This is not a real dog. Costumes from stars of the past, like Shirley Temple, are available to see at the museum, as are costumes from classic movies like Ben-Hur, and The Ten Commandments. Both of these movies star Charlton Heston. Sylvester Stallone's robe he wore as the Italian Stallion in the Rocky movies is a wonderful exhibit to see at the museum. The Hollywood Museum is a place where Hollywood's past still lives on.